الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك اللهم سبحانك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، معترفين بسلطانك، حامدين شاكرين لنعمائك. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يديم علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة، وأن يلهمنا العزم والعزيمة والصبر والثبات على أن نحمده على تلك النعماء. اللهم آمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يحيي ويميت، وهو حي لا يموت، وهو على كل شيء قدير، شهادة قامت بها السماوات والأرض. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمنا إياها لحظة لقائه. اللهم آمين. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما تجزي به مرسلا ونبيا. اللهم شفعه فينا شفاعة لا نعذب بعدها أبدا. اللهم اسقنا من حوضه شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم أمين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم طب القلوب ودواؤها، وعافية الأبدان وشفاؤها، ونور الأبصار وضياؤها. صلى عليك الله يا عالم الهدى، ما هبت النسائم وما ناحت على الأيك الحمائم. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, sons and daughters, the future of Islam, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. Wonderful and a great friends who have been watching us live via the internet, watching our Friday sermon from all over. Jazakumullahu khairan. Few weeks back, I was thinking about a topic to address, to share with you, given the situation we're in, the COVID-19, the coronavirus, how many people have been suffering all over the world. In numbers, subhanallah, yani, it's over 2 million. Here in America, some sources are saying 200,000, some other sources are saying 300. We do not know exactly. I looked at the impact of what is going on regarding the COVID-19 from death, sickness, illness, suffering, losing jobs, losing business, that a specific area where I am specialized in, the mental, psychological, emotional aspect of our life, and how much of negative impact we're having, of fear, anxiety, depression, lack of sleep, you name it. Especially when it comes to that area, money, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help. Food, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give. It is ibtila, as I mentioned last week, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in fear and lack of food and money and death and sickness and so on and so forth. But that issue of the mental, psychological and emotional negative impact we do have, how we can deal with that situation, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can help. I kept looking for some teaching till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided me to find out what al-Imam al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu wa arda wa rahimahullah is telling us. Oh, hey, You're looking for some components of happiness in order to overcome those sadness and grief, and you're looking for those components. Here they are. And he provided us, radiallahu anhu arda, with 13 components of happiness in order to overcome all of those sadness and grief and anxiety and so on and so forth. When I looked at them, wallahi, one by one, and analyzed what he said, was he specialized in psychotherapy? As a psychologist, psychotherapist, counselor, psychiatrist, or what? But we know Imam Shafi'i, radiallahu anhu arda, rahimahullah. So far, I covered 9 of them in previous Friday sermon. You may look at the record. Alhamdulillah, they are available, inshallah. Go to Facebook and put my name, all of them will come out. Except the one of last week. No, last week was yani exceptional. The election and COVID-19 and how we handle. Though it has part of that anxiety as well and fear. What the future is hiding for us after that new administration took place after those 4 years of whoever. I do not want to mention names or anything. Anyhow, with the Imam Shafi'i radiallahu anhu arda, I'm going to mention the first 9 one just by title, but go back to them. I put a lot of emphasis and explanation and thought about them. And we'll go for the last 2 ones, and we'll have another session in order to analyze why Shafi'i radiallahu anhu arda has chosen those 13 particular components of happiness, as-sa'adah, in our life. The first one he talked about, saying, اجعل الفرح شكرا. You're happy, but turn that happiness and pleasure to be thankful and grateful to Allah. 1. 2. والحزن صبرا. Are you in grief? You're sad? Go to sabur, sabur, sabur. Be patient. Be patient. Subhanallah. والصمت فكرة. If you choose to be quiet in some specific ways or situations, but while you're quiet, think and reflect deeply about things going on in your life. والنطق ذكرى. If you have to speak, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even in whatever you're saying, remember Allah is watching you and hearing you and witnessing you. If you choose just dhikr by dhikr, any kind of dhikr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to say, do. If not, and you have to speak about something, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. Wal hayata ta'a, your life. We're taking our life, work hard, study hard, earn money, make money, do this business, do that. Please take your life as an act of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In anything you do, studying, obedience. Business, obedience. Traveling, obedience. Talking, obedience, whatever. Ta'ah. Ta'ah. With the full meaning of it. وَكُنْ مِثْلَ الطَّائِرِ يَأْتِيهِ رِزْقُهُ كُلَّ صَبَاحٍ وَمَسَاءٍ. Live your life like a little bird. Your food is coming to you no matter what, morning and evening, like a little bird. Don't worry about your food and what you're eating. It's coming to you. It is coming to you, wallahi, no matter what. Don't worry about your rizq. Don't worry about it. ولا تؤذي أحدا. Don't harm anyone. don't cause any problem to anyone around you. ليكن قلبك كاللؤلؤ. Your heart, do your best to have it as pearl, clean, pure. Don't add anything to your heart. Otherwise, it will carry all of those ahqad. You dislike this, you don't like this, you hate this, and so on and so forth. وَكِنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ أَوْ عَابِرُ سَبِيلٌ. Live your life in this dunya, take it as you're not living for eternal life. It is a temporary life. It's a stage of your extended life. Here, few years, and then leave, go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَصَلِّ صَلَاةً مُوَدَّعًا. When you pray, as if it is your last prayer, no more prayer. If it is your last prayer, your last meeting with Allah, how this prayer would be. We say, Allah, this is my last farewell. I will meet you in Jannah, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen. وَرْقُدْ كَأَنَّكَ شَهِيدٌ. When you go to sleep, as if you're shaheed, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will never wake up again. If you look at those 9 components, if you combine all of them in your life, wallahi, no doubt, all happiness will come to your life, all pleasure. You will never think of anything bad, anything negative in your life, according to Al-Imam Al-Shafi'i, radiallahu anhu wa arda. So these are the first 9 components. It took 1, 2, 3, 4 sessions of Friday sermon to talk about the details of those one. You can go to them. Now when we're talking about number 11 and number 12 and 13, the three of them. First one. لا تتكلم. Are you paying enough attention? بكلام تعتذر منه. Don't say anything, but after a while you find out that, I said something wrong. I said something bad. I hurt someone in what I'm doing. If you're conscious enough of what you said, and you feel that you said something wrong, you hurt someone's feeling, you said something bad, negative, I should apologize. But why in the first place you say something wrong? In order to put yourself in that situation, you have to have an apology for someone. I don't have to put myself in that situation. Keeping in mind, watch your tongue. Watch what your tongue is saying. لسانك لا تذكر به عورة امرئ فكلك عورات وللناس ألسن. Your tongue never mention anything bad with someone else by your tongue, because you yourself has many wrong things. And if I say once to one person, another person, a third person around me, I am only one, but around me many to whom I said something wrong. Can you imagine they will reply to what you're saying? Bad, 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 nasty things. How are you going to feel? Remember. فَكُلُّكَ عَوْرَاتٌ وَلِلنَّاسِ أَلْسُنُ. You have many shortcomings in your life. People easily would reply to what you said. I said, you're a liar to someone. Do you think that someone would say, am I a liar? You are such and such and such. Can I say more? And such and such and such. Can I say more? And such and such and such. And that's what nursing. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us that أمسك عليك لسانك. Guide your tongue. Guard your tongue. Hold your tongue. He's teaching the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. And the Sahaba are wondering and asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yani, clearly, and they want to have more explanation, want to have just some justification in order to watch their tongue in what they are saying, asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أو نحن مؤاخذون بما نتكلم به أو بما نتفوه به يا رسول الله؟ Are we held accountable in what we are saying or the messenger of Allah? يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى will record what we're saying, good or bad. But they thought, you know, if I talk. If I say something, oh, I say something. Oh, we're in a free country. I can say whatever I want to say. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم answered them, وهل يكب الناس على وجوههم أو على مناخرهم يوم القيامة إلا حصائد ألسنتهم؟ What would drag people down on earth in the day of judgment, or drag them in their noses on the ground on the day of judgment, what their tongue said in this dunya? And when they are dragged down on their faces, on their noses, in the day of judgment, everyone around is, aha! He was saying something bad, utilizing his tongue in a bad way in the dunya. We know who you are now. You want to be at that situation in the day of judgment? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is warning us what we say. Think of your life. Wallahi. In your relationship with people around you, we're not using our hands. We're peaceful, right? Right, Mahmoud? We're not hitting anyone, we're not kicking anyone. But most of the time, we're not looking a lot of time about, someone, your shirt doesn't look good for me, but you're seeing and you're saying. So most of the time, we're saying something in our relationship to people around us. Hi, how you doing? Or hello, in a very nasty way. Watch your tongue. This is your way to reach out to people, to communicate with people, to be in a good relationship with people. Your tongue. And it is recorded. Wallahi, the malaika are recording whatever you said. So amsik alayka lisanik. Lisanuka la tadhkur bihi awrata mri'in fakulluka awratun walinnasi alsunu. Once you do this, I'm happy. No one would reply to what I'm saying. No one would retaliate about what I said wrong or bad or negative. I'm in peace with myself. I'm in peace with people. I'm happy. But can you imagine you go from one person to another one, third one, fourth one, during the whole day, how many people have replied to what you said wrong or bad to them? You can't stand it. You can't live it. You can't live with it. The whole day, sadness, grief, depression, I cannot stand it anymore. Because what my tongue is saying. Watch your tongue. So this is one thing. If we're really, 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 really careful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would help us tremendously. One more thing, in order to bring happiness to our life. I live my life that there are many people in my life who oppressed me. ظلموني. I am living ظلم. They were not fair with me. No justice. In my relationship with my parents, not fair. With my brothers and sister, they treated me very badly. With my friends, never be on my side, always against me. Neighbors, people around, Muslims, non-Muslims, mazloom. I've been oppressed. I've been suppressed. Remember, should I retaliate? They say something bad to me. Should I say something bad to them? And double, and triple, and as four times as I can, in order to retaliate, in order to no. Wallahi, one word in the Quran. In the Quran. Not even in the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say it and you will see the outcome. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah is more than enough. He's the one who taking care of me and helping me in a situation where I am oppressed and suppressed and people are not just not fair with me. The outcome of just saying Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel tutfi'ul hariq. Fire is going on because someone يعني ظلمني unjust with me, I have to defend myself. Now it is fire. You cannot even call 911 or fire department to distinguish that fire. No. It is a big fight. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, distinguish it. This is your call. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, coming from the depth of your heart. تطفئ الحريق وينجو بها الغريق. يعني someone caused you to be sunk deep, deep, deep in water because of what he said or what he did or what they did for you. ظلم, oppression, suppression. I die out of this. Okay? Allah will save you. ويعرف بها الطريق. Once you said it, you know your way away from all of this. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. I want to refer you to the ayah in Al Imran, chapter 3. 173. Some people would come to say to you, here is what people have been saying or planning to suppress you or be unjust with you. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم. Those believers unto whom people, hypocrites at that time, said verily people, the pagans, the non-believers, have gathered against you great army. Therefore, fear them. That's very obvious oppression and suppression and injustice against the Muslim, against the believers, against the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once they hear that statement, once you hear a similar statement of injustice or suppression or oppression from someone, Allah will do for what? Do what for you? Therefore, fear them. But it only increases them in faith. Subhanallah. They will oppress me. I'm heavily dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking care of me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is helping me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking care of them. I believe in Him. That's it. I'm not afraid of them. They will never do nothing for me. Once you say, Subhanallah. فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Wait away. They said, Allah alone is sufficient for us and He is the best disposer of affairs for us. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Remember this wallahi. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. What happened to them? What is the outcome? Just by saying and believing in that statement. فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ وَاتَّبَعُوا رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allahu Akbar. Look at the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they return with grace and bounty from Allah. No harm touches them. And they follow the good pleasure of Allah. And Allah is the owner of great bounty. Just by saying, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Yes, try it. يعني, you have someone who ظلمaka. يعني, sit to yourself and say, Ya Allah, with that person. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. But let it come sincerely from the depth of your heart. You will feel happy. Why? Why? أنت لا تلجأ إلى محكمة الدنيا وقاضي الدنيا ومحامي الدنيا، ولكنك تلجأ إلى قاضي الكون ومحام عنك هو الله، وهو الذي يمدك بالعدل والعدالة والبراءة. Go hire an attorney for someone who did something for you. It's a person. It's a human being. And you pay money and money and money and go in front of the judge. That's a human being. That's a human being. And you are a human being. And that person is a human being. Whether you win this case or not, Allahu A'lam. Allahu A'lam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best. Knowing that whether you win this case or you do not win this case, but he's still suffering. Here's one hearing and another hearing. Oh, sorry, COVID-19, we'll have a virtual hearing. Oh, we cannot talk. We cannot. It takes forever and you're suffering. You have money? Save it. You have time? Save it. You have energy? Save it. You have that person who caused this dhulm to you? Ya Allah. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. That's it. You file that case too? Allah, don't find it somewhere else. Pleasure, happiness, tranquility, relaxing will come to your life. I don't have to waste my time, waste my energy, waste my money against someone who unjust to me, unfair to me, who caused me the dhulm. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. رحمك الله يا إمامنا الشافعي، رحمك الله. لازلنا في رحاب المصطفى. البر لا يبلى والذنب لا ينسى والديان لا يموت. كل ابن آدم خطاء، وخير الخطائين التوابون، والتائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, sons and daughters, the future of Islam, our wonderful friends all over the world have been watching our Friday sermon alive. Jazakumullahu khairan. I'm afraid I'm going to close my business as a psychotherapist. People would come to me asking for some help, counseling. I'm depressed. Do I have anxiety? I cannot sleep. I lost my appetite. I don't eat good anymore. I don't sleep good anymore. Oh, can you do something for me? Don't come to me. Go to Imam al-Shafi'i. Wallahi. Wallahi, I'm sincere. Go to Imam al-Shafi'i. Or if you decide to come to me, I will teach you what Imam al-Shafi'i is saying. See, after all of these years of studying back home and here and PhD and master's degree and training, and now you're telling me Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, مقومات السعادة, yes. That's why I'm heavily dependent in my psychotherapy and my counseling on the teaching of Islam. In one like Al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu arda. I look at all references of psychology and psychotherapy to find something similar to this. I did not find any. I did not. And I'm too expensive, by the way, too. Can you afford it? I have the insurance. How about if the insurance is not covering all of those sessions of psychotherapy? Are you going to pay me? Answer me. This is free. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu arda had the components of happiness to your life. I'm going to go to the psychiatrist. He will give me some bills. If I want to sleep, one bill. Did sleep like a baby. Depression, antidepressant pills, and I'm fine. Be my guest. The antidepressant now causing suicide. The side effects of the other things like sleeping pills and da-da-da-da-da, look at the side effects. Wallahi today, subhanAllah Rabbil Alameen, my wife, while I was about to come in here, calling back home Egypt, her sister, she has a very, very, very severe يعني حساسية محمود allergy. How are you doing? What's the medication? Did you go to your doctor? I said, wallahi, I went to the doctor three times, three different ones, give me medication, three different medication, but guess what? The first one increased the allergy, not to cure it. Second one made it worse. Third one worse and worse and worse. This is just allergy. We don't look at the side effects. With the psychological, mental, and emotional aspect, when you do have all of those drugs, side effects. The largest second business in this country is the pharma, after arms. And I wish they are working well. No, they are not. Go to Shafi for free. Go to the teaching of Shafi. But they teach you our Friday sermon in order to have that tranquility, that comfort, that happiness, that pleasure in your life. You'll be the happiest ever, and you show people how you live. We did not come to number 11, but inshallah next week we have some analysis of the connection between all of them. How Allah subhanahu, how Shafi radiallahu anhu Allah put all of them this way. Why he chose those specific 13 factors of happiness in our life. I will share with you inshallah rabbil alameen. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alameen. Innaka hamidun majid. Ma min yawm jum'atin illa wa fihi sa'atu ijabah. Nadu Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khashi'ina, dari'ina an takuna hadhihi as-sa'ah. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعلي بفضلك راية الحق والدين وانصرنا على عدوك وعدونا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصر أمة محمد وجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل أمة محمد ولا تجعلنا منهم. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي وعصمة أمرنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم آمنا في روعاتنا. اللهم كن لنا ولا تكن علينا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا وفك أسرانا وكن لنا ولا تكن علينا.